just arrived here at Ashwag Hall, and it's going to be another show out in East Hampton, and we're going to take a look at some of the photography hanging on the walls, and we're going to meet the person that's running the show and tell us what the show is and what's going on with the show. So I'm going to look for my friend Jerry, and we'll see where we can find him. Live on Zenbox Forte. I said I would find him, and I did. Hi, Jerry. Zen.
Hey. Yeah.
So I'm here at Ashwag Hall once again.
Yes, this is our 21st year.
21 years. You don't look like a day over 21.
I know. It's true. Yeah, 21 years. The East End Photographers Group started here in Springs, and we've been going every year, having an exhibit here every year. Sometimes in the early spring, sometimes in the late spring. And this time it's a little more in the late spring.
So it's spring at Springs.
Spring at Springs, yeah. Spring has sprung at Springs.
But it might be summer now, almost.
Yeah. And we have about 25 participants, members. We have about 65 members, but only 25 or 30, you know, show at a certain time. People are doing different things, you know, throughout the year. And sometimes they can show, sometimes they can't. And you know, we're going to have some music tonight, and
you said members.
Yes.
What do you mean by a member?
Well, we have a lot of different types of photographers that are in our group. You have commercial people, people just starting out, people who have been doing it for a while, just doing fine artwork, and other people that you know, have weddings, things like that.
So it takes it takes an interest in photography, and I take it maybe some money to be a member.
Well, there's a little fee to be a member, and then we have to get money together to rent the hall.
Absolutely.
That, you know?
That's why I said that. Everybody has groups, and groups require dues, and if you have an interest, usually you can be a member.
Yes.
You don't have to be published, or you don't have to have the top Nikon
or
whatever. So if you can come in here with a camera and an interest and pay dues, you could be a member.
Usually. We like to see people's work, see what they're doing first, you know. We usually have adults. In the past, we had a few young people. That were the high school people and things like that, but it's mostly adults in this group.
So anybody seeing this show on any of the cable systems besides East Hampton, I want you to know have a reason to move to East Hampton. So you can migrate out here, you'll love it, and this is a good reason to get into a East End Photography group.
Yes, and our website is eastendphotogroup.org.
.org.
Yes.
Because you're an organization.
Yes. We have a .com too, but we have both.
Oh, you have both. Yeah. Okay. And one takes you to the other anyway.
Yeah. eastendphotogroup.org.
All right. So now I know why we're here.
Yeah.
And we have a vast range of photographers that we've met in the past that work from anything from a very inexpensive camera to an expensive camera to darkroom to computerized.
We have a lot of people doing digital work now, almost exclusively. We have a few diehards, including myself, that do black and white. I didn't do black and white this time. I have digital work, but we do have a few people here that are doing
no solar wet. No solar stuff this year?
No, I didn't do any solar prints this year.
We'll talk about that. We'll show a repeat.
But we do have people that are doing black and white, you know, traditional wet darkroom work. But a lot of people are doing digital. And it looks great. You've got some great stuff.
Interesting for the, I've noticed, not that this is important, in an art show, and this is not a big deal, I've seen even some nude women in
the
art.
Yes, we have a number of nude women in the show that
shows art.
That shows art. And this year, there's more than normal.
When we show the collage, I just want everybody out there not to be upset. Yeah. It's art.
Yeah.
Not anything more than art. I just want to explain that because I'm going to get that. So, you know, but anyway, would you like to show some of your work? Could we do that?
Yeah, we can do that.
All right, we're going to take a walk. So you can all walk with us this way. Okay, Jerry, we did this wild move, and here we are. And I'm going to let you talk about each piece, so I'm going to get behind the camera and so they can see each piece. So this is yours.
Oh, I can take this? Okay.
Zenbach is going to vamoose.
All right. Okay. So this year I did some things with Photoshop, and I was trying to make them look like fake copper plates. Some of them worked, some of them didn't work. This one was an Indian dancer that was at Watermill, at the Watermill facility over there. And That one is a little red, and it didn't get the effect I wanted. This is something I composed, and it's the Dead Sea Scrolls. This is a statue that I found in Nuremberg in Germany. And that one seemed to work. It seemed to work for the copper plate. And this is also, this is in Italy at the Tivoli Garden area where they have all of these different types of fountains. And this one I found in Patagonia, I think. It was outside of Tucson. And it was an old house, and they had all of these skeletons and all these different things. And so I tried to create that copper plate feel. This is Silver's over in Southampton. It's in the back of the parking lot by the Parish Art Museum. And Silver's has been there as long as I can remember, from the 70s. They've been probably there in the 60s. It's a restaurant. And in the back, they have their name on the back of this big building. So these are the things I'm working on. And I guess we'll probably go on and look at some of the other members' work.
I am Zenbach, and you are?
My name is Anne Drager.
Anne, you have behind me a wall of photography. So before I ask you to talk about each piece, what do you shoot with?
Oh, I shoot film most of the time. Well, at least everything that is here
in this
is
room?
Film.
Yeah. Film. Wow.
I don't know. It's just, it gets crazier and crazier to do film. I'm aware of that. But, you know, I like
35 millimeter?
Yes.
So what kind of camera?
It's a very basic Nikon, like semi-automatic, and it's, I think, an N75.
I guess you like the manual.
I would even do a manual, but, you know, I don't mind.
Whatever works.
Whatever the camera, the features they have, I use it.
All right. Before I even get to that, I noticed you have a handbag.
Yes.
Okay. And I'll take a close-up of that in a second. And I like the idea that the artwork has been utilized more than just in the photos. Excuse us, we just lost a picture there. Okay. All right, somebody walked in the shot. Anyway, so the other thing I noticed is you have some beautiful jewelry.
Thank you.
And nice outfit. So I have a feeling I'm dealing with a multi-artist.
Well, yeah, I like to work in different media, and actually this is just one way of using the photography, and I have pieces that I made of fabric, because I love working with fabric, and print, that's, you know, fiber prints, especially like the black and white, so I would cut up the prints and use the sewing machine and fabric, and then, you know, do either two-dimensional or, you know,
I love the whole idea of the multi forms of art. I'm going to hand the mic, and then I'm going to disappear behind the camera, and you can work from picture to picture and give me a little explanation on it.
Okay.
So here's a mic just for you.
All right, thanks, Zen. All right, so these three photographs here are all taken in Venice. I went to Venice for about 2 months in the winter of 2006, and well, for, you know, the usual special reasons that people have to go to Venice. It was, you know, it's a romantic story that is behind these. And this series is called Letters to Venice. So I'm writing a letter here. And you see how the Bridge of Sighs is superimposed on the letter writing. And here you have a sole luna in a romantic scene, also with the Bridge of Sighs. And then there is the rose on some old Venetian stone. So it's just, Venice is very conducive to getting into very romantic ideas, and that's how these things came about pretty much. So, and over here, there's another piece of Italy. I'm a great fan of Italy. And by the way, this the picture on the purse is me in a fountain in Florence. And this is Turin in Italy. This is the cathedral, which is one of the most photographed buildings of the city, the Cathedral of Turin. And then we have the eye here in a close-up. And, well, I don't know. I think the picture pretty much speaks for itself. It's also a double exposure. And This is a black and white print from a different time and place. It's I took this picture in Montauk, where I make my home. And you know, usually there is nature, so we have the grass. And I took this picture after a period of illness, where I suffered from hallucinations and headaches and all sorts of problems related to the head. So this is part of a series that captures the recovery and the emotions related to that time of illness, and it's called Grass Face. And that's it.
Well, that's a lot. That's a lot. That's a lot. How does one get to model and take a picture?
Oh, well, this
like I'm doing right now.
Right, this is just a portrait, so I probably held the camera.
Okay.
But there's other pictures where I use a tripod and a remote control photograph myself.
All right. So what I'm really noticing here is a very active mind with a lot of application and a lot of interest. And I too have I'm a multimedia artist. So I appreciate the diversity of the applications of the photography you're doing. So, well, I thank you very much for your time.
All right.
Yeah, you got to come down to the show. You have to come down and see the show. It's a beautiful show. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm with Anne.
I'm Anne Brandeis.
And I'm Zenbach. And we're in a very bad location with some really nice art. And I mean bad because it's right by the door. So. Yes, we are.
Sorry.
Turn around and say hi to the camera.
Where do you
turn around?
Hi, camera.
I teach at Marymount Manhattan College in the city.
It's all right. Like I said, it's a very busy place, so it's going to be a very interesting interview. I'm going to hand you the mic, but before I go, you have large prints, and large prints usually lose all kinds of resolution, and you have sharp photography, so I'm going to ask you what kind of camera you use.
I use a Canon. I use the brand new D5,
okay.
21 megapixels.
Well, there you go, there you go. And that's digital.
Digital, I work digitally, and I print all of my own work, and I work in the digital darkroom.
Well, there you go, digital darkroom, interesting. I've never heard of a digital darkroom.
And from that, we make digital negatives. So we still use the same terminology, and the work is the same, but we're working from a new construct.
Amazing. I learn something every day. I'm going to hand you the mic, and you can talk about the photos. And what's going to happen is you're going to see people walking through. And there's not much I can do about that, because, like I said, our location for television is bad, but really good if you come down here.
I'm Ann Brandeis. And you're at a gallery opening, and the gallery is filled to the rafters. Additionally, we are having a party, so we have a band in the background. The show is the Ashwag Hall show that members of the photography group put on each year. The pieces that I have behind are my organic images. They represent people, in this particular case women, but not always, and how we relate to nature, how we relate to the earth, and sometimes how we relate to our own feelings and our own emotions. The first piece I call Siren Song, if you can see that. So I have a woman who is reclining in the field, and she is sensually reclining and becoming part of the field and part of the water. The second image is Tiger Moth. It's neither a tiger nor a moth. It's a woman who has morphed. Is she a butterfly? Well, yes and no. She is her own being, but her beauty has come out. She is both reticent in her body mannerisms, and yet she is a tiger. She has thrown out all of her colors, and she also is very sensual. And the last piece I have here, which is going to be hard to read, it's a lot of reflections, is Between the Walls, and this also represents a woman being caught between, to me, life and life's feelings, life's energy. My work is right now being shown in Fine Arts Magazine. I teach at Marymount Manhattan College. I have been doing photography for 20-odd years, and I love the expressiveness that I can utilize in the digital darkroom, that I can make things become my reality. And thank you for your time.
Well, I got you on camera, and we're going to let everybody see this, and even in the internet. So how long have you been involved with here doing this?
With Ashwag Hall? The two groups that I belong with, about 8 or 9 years. The art community tends to come to Ashwag Hall. It has an old history of being part of the art community in the 1950s, and a lot of the people at the gallery are artists looking at other artists' work, and are coming together, and also people in the neighborhood.
So it is a community thing. It definitely an East Hampton community. Well, I appreciate your time.
Oh, thank you. I enjoyed this very much.
Live on Zenbox Forte.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Well, I'm in a corner. And I'm with, I guess I'm here with Ruth. Mm-hmm. And Ruth, you are Ruth Hallett, right?
Right.
Ruth mm-hmm. Hallett. And this is a first year showing?
Second
year. Then I didn't get to interview you yet.
Last year I was in the October show.
Okay, and I wasn't here, so we missed. All right. I'm going to ask you to talk about your artwork.
Okay.
Well, your photographs. But I'm going to hand you the mic.
Okay.
So I can make the camera do its thing.
Okay,
so you hold this.
Okay.
I'll be back.
Okay, and I'll stand this way. Well, they're pretty much all the same thing. They're the Ferris wheel in the Tuileries, Place de la Concorde in Paris. It's my favorite city in the world. And they're three very different shots. This one was taken in October at sunset, and I was very pleased when it came out that this shadow over here of the water was sort of like Impressionism, not that I'm comparing myself to the Impressionists, but it's certainly an Impressionist strokes in the water, and that the water that was sprayed from the Ferris wheel by the wind was so clear. These two were taken last November. They were taken in color, and they came out practically in black and white. This is the Place de la Concorde. I like the juxtaposition of the very old, the statue, and the very new. And that was the close-up, which came out sort of like a sunflower in a bleak November day.
Okay, Ruth. Now, I missed your show in October.
Mm-hmm.
But I take it you're a member of the East End mm-hmm. already, and you would be an East End artist then.
I guess so.
All righty. And let me ask you a little questions. What kind of camera do you shoot?
This one was done with an HP. These two were done with a Nikon Coolpix.
Okay, HP is a what?
A digital, just a point-and-shoot digital camera that's no longer made, and it died, and I'm very upset.
Okay. And your medium on this, on the digital, would be color printers?
Yes.
All right. And so I guess you end up with a knowledge of Photoshop as well, then.
Very little. The only thing I had to Photoshop was the date, and then I stopped putting dates on my pictures.
Okay.
So I just had the little date in here on the water and had to Photoshop that out. Otherwise, I did not use Photoshop.
The first thing I noticed when I walked in this room was the sunflower almost. And there's almost a humor in that, too. It's a standalone shot.
Mm-hmm.
So I really like that.
Thanks.
So, all right. Well, I hope to see you next year. We're here every year.
Okay. I'll
live,
be next year.
Live on Zenbox Forte. Hey.
Thank you.
Painless. Okay, I'm in another corner. And I've got a photographer with me. And I've got close-ups of flowers. And I've got bugs, too. Bugs. Thomas.
Yes.
All right. First of all, what kind of camera are you shooting with?
I'm shooting with a Nikon D200.
And I would have to ask you what kind of lens you got looking at your work.
Well, with this, most of these shots, as a matter of fact, all of these shots, I used a 105, and some of them I used it as a macro lens.
Right, okay. Yeah, I'm familiar with old Vivitar macro zooms, and sliding into that macro position is a lot of fun.
Right.
You know, definitely get a lot of tight composition.
Yeah, some of these are extremely...
Are these handheld? Usually with a macro, on mine, I always did tripods.
All of these are... This is handheld, that's handheld, and that's handheld.
Wow, I'm impressed.
So that's handheld as well. Only these three, the rose and the white flower and the lily.
Yeah, I'm like this with a handheld. I'm going to hand the mic. I'm going to get out of picture, and you can talk about each one as you like.
Okay.
So if you can start from one corner and work your way around.
Okay, fine. Well, this particular one in the upper right-hand corner is a dragonfly, and I actually took about 300 pictures of it. And it was very difficult because I was using a macro lens, but the dragonfly was nice enough to stay around while I took the pictures. This one here was taken right next to the Andy Warhol estate. It's basically a beetle, Japanese beetle, with some of its handiwork on the bottom of the picture. This one here is a white flower that's prevalent in Montauk and actually in the East End. And this was taken in the studio with special lighting. This was taken basically in front of my house, the lily. This was actually 12 pictures taken at different focal lengths and then layered together so as to make a very precise depth of field in that particular picture. This one here was handheld, simply a bee on a thistle. And one of the remarkable parts of this is the wings. And not only that, but the hair on the back of the bee kind of coincides with the top of the thistle. This one here I call Tendril. And that was taken close to Montauk Point early in the morning. And it's just an interesting shot with all the water droplets. This one here is kind of interesting. This was taken in the studio. And actually, the flower itself couldn't have been more than 4 inches. And once again, I used that process where I took at least a dozen photographs, layered them, and then brought them together to get tremendous depth of field. And basically, what I'm trying to do with this body of work is to show that there's a level of intricacy and a level of sight that the average individual doesn't get involved with, especially in something like a rose or the lily. And most people don't get that close to a dragonfly, nor a bee for that matter.
Once again, I'm impressed.
Why, thank you.
And I love the work.
Thank you.
And I'm allergic to bees, but I like them like that. I like them like that.
You know. That's a fairly safe bee.
That's a safe bee. Yeah. Well, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
And we'll see what else we can get into here.